In this example, we use the method of initial rates to determine the rate law for a reaction, and then predict the initial rate for different starting conditions. Our problem reads, from the experimental data given, predict the initial rate when the concentration of X equals 0.30 molar, the concentration of Y equals 0.15 molar, and the concentration of Z equals 0.10 molar for the reaction X plus 3Y plus 2Z produces Q plus 2T. We're also given the experimental data in the table for four experiments with different starting conditions. When we set up experiments for the method of initial rates, we want to systematically change the concentration of one reactant at a time to determine what effect the change has on the overall initial rate of the reaction. This allows us to isolate the effect on rate for each reactant. We'll start by writing out the rate law for the reaction. Once we have completed the rate law, we can substitute in the values given in the problem. The rate is equal to the rate constant, K, times the concentration of X raised to the m power, times the concentration of Y raised to the n power, times the concentration of Z raised to the p power. To find the values of our exponents m, n, and p, we need to compare the initial rate for two reactions where only one of the reactant's initial concentration is different. We'll first find M. If we look at the starting concentrations in our table, in experiments 3 and 4, the only initial concentration that changes is the concentration of X. So we'll write out the ratio of the rate law substituting in our values for reactions 3 and 4. If we plug in our values from the table, we see that on the left side of the equation, our initial rate has doubled going from experiment 3 to 4. On the right side of the equation, the rate constant cancels out, and so does the initial concentrations of Y and Z. We're left with just the ratio of the initial concentrations of X raised to the m power. To solve this, since both concentrations are raised to the m power, we can bring the fraction inside the parentheses and raise it to the m power. Simplifying the fraction, we see it is 2 raised to the m power. Although we know m is 1 just by looking at this equation, let's solve this all the way using math, in case the numbers don't turn out so easily in other problems. To solve for m, we need to take the log of both sides. We get the log of 2 equals the log of 2 raised to the m power. When you take the log of a number raised to a power, the power can be taken out of the log as a multiplication factor. So on the right, it becomes m times the log of 2. Then we can divide both sides by the log of 2 to solve for m. As we anticipated, m equals 1. We can plug this into our rate equation. Next, we'll find n. If we look at the starting concentrations in our table, in experiments 2 and 4, the only initial concentration that changes is the concentration of Y. So we'll write out the ratio of the rate law substituting in our values for reactions 2 and 4. Instead of going through all of the math steps, let's reason out what n should be, since our numbers are very clean. On the left, we have the ratio of initial rates, which is 4 when we plug in our numbers from the table. Our rate is quadrupled. The only change we made when we went from experiment 4 to experiment 2 is that we doubled the concentration of Y. So on the right, we'll just have the ratio of the initial concentrations of Y, which is 2, raised to the n power. So when we doubled the concentration of Y, our initial rate quadrupled. This is a square relationship, so n equals 2. We could also use math to solve this equation, taking the log of both sides. But, as we mentioned, our numbers are very clear. Next, we'll find P. If we look through our experiments, in experiments 1 and 4, the only initial concentration that changes is the concentration of Z. When we doubled the concentration of Z, our initial rate did not change. This means our rate does not depend on Z. And P must equal 0. Since P equals 0, we can remove it from the rate equation. Our last step is to find the rate constant K. We can do this by choosing any of the rows from our experimental data and substituting the values into our rate equation. I'll choose the data for experiment 1. Plugging in experiment 1, we get 0.080 molar per second equals the rate constant K times 0.050 molar times 0.10 molar squared. Multiplying out the right side, we get K times 0.0050 molar cubed. Solving for K, we get 16 molar to the negative second times seconds to the negative first. We can substitute this value of K into our complete rate equation. To double check that we solved the problem correctly, we should be able to plug in data from any of the rows for an experiment and come out with the measured initial rate for that experiment. Our last step is to plug in the initial concentrations given in the problem to predict the initial rate under different conditions. Since our rate only depends on the concentrations of X and Y, the concentration of Z is ignored. Completing the calculation, we get 0.11 molar per second.